guys, and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new, welcome. For today's video, I'm going to be doing the No Mirror Makeup Challenge. This is my third attempt to do it. I don't have somebody behind the camera, like, telling me if it stops or anything, so I'm just having to guess. I don't have my viewfinder on, that's why it's so difficult right now, because I don't want to have to use anything. I don't have a mirror on me or anything for this challenge. So yeah, I feel like my face is pretty red and my eyes are irritated and my skin's pretty irritated. I'm having to do my makeup 3 times. I got halfway into my eyeshadow and every time it stopped and I didn't realize. I wanted to try out this challenge just because it's fun, a good experience, you know, you get grateful for mirrors. That's a way to put it. And I've seen a lot of people do this challenge before. It's not a new trend or anything, but I've just seen so many people do it. I haven't done it on my channel yet, so I figure, you know, why not show how bad I can do my makeup without a mirror? So, because I know it's going to be bad. I rely on my mirror a lot, like a lot, a lot. Hope you guys enjoy this video, and I hope you guys can find it fun to watch. Without further ado, let's just jump right into the video. Just to show you guys some proof, this is my table. I have all my stuff right there. There's my eyeshadow palette stuff I was using. I have nothing right here, no mirror, and then there's nothing going on over here.
I'm honestly hoping I'm in frame because now I can't even tell. I have nothing to show. So yeah, I'm gonna start all over again for the 3rd time, putting on my primer. Use this primer. All these products, they're going to be ran out by the time this video goes up. If this video goes up, then I finally figured it out after 3 times. So, yeah, I'm just going to take that green primer. It's the LA Girl Correcting Primer. And just put this all over my face because I'm pretty sure my skin's red by now. I don't know why I put it on my fingers. I never put it on my fingers. So, my skin kind of burns now, taking off my makeup for 3 times. Figured since this is my 3rd time doing this, I'm gonna switch up my products now. Today's foundation, I'm gonna use the Fit Me foundation. I've had this foundation for so long. This is a matte foundation, something I don't really use because I just want to try it out today. So I think that was too much. Anyway, so I'm gonna take my flat brush and take some of this and take the hair off first and then wipe it on my face. I'm pretty sure that I can kind of guess where this is going. Oh, my face really burns. I wonder why. I'm gonna take that flat side and blend it out. I feel like my face is gonna be the easiest thing just because I love putting on my face makeup. Like, if I could put on anything, it'd be my face makeup and my foundation. My face makeup and my mascara, I mean. Those are the 2 things that I would be doing on a daily. Those are the only things I could do, so. I honestly feel like I've gotten it all. This beauty sponge is pretty big on this side, so I think I've gotten it all. The next thing I'm gonna go in with is this ColourPop concealer. It's a pretty fresh one, and this is in the shade Light 40W. That seems like enough. I don't put much concealer on, so I feel like that's enough. And I'm just going to blend that out with the tip of my beauty sponge. And put some on my eyelid. And I don't think I mentioned, but I don't even have my contacts in. So even if I really wanted to see a mirror far away, I wouldn't be able to see a mirror far away. Or anything, honestly, because everything in front of me is pretty blurred as is. So, yeah. I'm taking this challenge to the next step, so it's no mirror, no viewfinder, no contacts, no vision wear. Alright, I feel like that's pretty blended. So now I'm going to go with my LA Girl powder. And I'm going to powder my under eyes first because that's what I always do. And powder my eyes, eyelids.
And then I'm gonna go with my powder puff and finish it off.
I feel like this powder's gonna be pretty easy because you just have to fill. And I can fill on my face like if there's a wet spot, so. I think that's pretty good, so I'm just gonna wipe off if there's any excess powder.
All right, the next three things I'm gonna do is bronzer, blush, and highlight. My bronzer, I'm gonna go in with this Hoola bronzer. And I'm gonna dip into there and do my cheekbones.
I feel like this brush is pretty easy to me. I feel like I might be like totally putting too much on or something, but I feel like I have a routine of doing two layers on each part of my face wherever I put my contour, so. Or three, because this has been three, I think. And on my nose. So I think I did it pretty good. I mean, I think it's pretty decent. I feel like it's pretty decent. I'm calculating in my head it's pretty decent. So yeah,
anyway. That's done. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go in with the truffle one. I know this has a mirror in it. That's why I'm just going to take my brush, swirl it around, and put my blush on because I don't want to look and cheat. A little more than one layer. Okay. That's done. I want to like overblend it because I know those are pretty pigmented. So the next thing I'm going to go in with is my Flower Beauty and put some on my cheekbones. This one's not like too pigmented. I've seen a lot of better highlighters, but this one's pretty good, so I'm gonna stick some on my cheekbones. I think I'm done with my face makeup. Now I'm gonna move on with my eyeshadow. My eyeshadow, I'm gonna take this big fluffy brush. I'm gonna go into the Anastasia Modern Renaissance palette. This does have a mirror in it, so I am going to flip the mirror around and have it face towards y'all. So this is the stuff I see. I'm going to go in with that Graciana, which is a light brown, and just put this on my crease. I have a feel like my eyeshadow is going to be pretty decent too, just because I have a feel for these brushes. We connect. So, and these are pretty pigmented, so I don't have to go like in like heavy-handed. Oh, I think I just... My nose itches. Next, I'm going to go in with this reddish burnt orange. And I'm going to put this in on my outer corner. I've never used this color, so hopefully this is... Ugh, my face. There's so much fuzzies on it. I use this color, so I don't know how pigmented it is or anything. So, we're just going to hope for the best and blend it out. We're blending. I feel so bored not looking in a mirror. I don't know what to do. I'm gonna fall asleep. Hopefully that's good. I mean, I don't know. I don't know. Y'all tell me if that's good enough or I should put more in my crease. Because I honestly don't know. I'm gonna take this clean fluffy brush and blend it out a little bit. I had a lot on there because it's picking up some pigment. I'm gonna go even darker. And I'm gonna put this purple shade on there with that fluffy brush. I'm just gonna put some of this in my crease. A little bit more just to darken it. I'm gonna darken this up. Go to the other side, and first time I'm actually using colors in a while, and it's gonna be purple where I have no mirror and where I cannot see myself. This is great. I wanted it to be a challenge for me. Now I'm going to do my shimmer, and I'm just going to do it with my finger because that has the most pigment. I'm going to put this antique bronze on there because that looks like, oh no, that's, I don't want it that dark. Like, yeah, that's pretty, but not for my lid. I'm going to go in with this goldish color. That's pretty. Put it on my lid. Get on there because I want it to be glowing. Three layers, so I'm gonna have to do three layers on this side. Here's gold. I'm gonna go in back with that purple brush and just
just clean it up a little bit. Because you know that shimmer is going to get on the outer corner, so I got to clean it up. Okay. And the last thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take this small little brush. I'm going to go in with this first shade. And I'm going to put that on my brow bone, my highlight, really quick. Alright. Oh my gosh. I totally forgot to do my brows. For my brows, I'm going to use this Benefit pencil. This is the Brow Microfilling Pen. It's their newer one. And I'm going to have to guess. So I'm going to brush my brows up. I'm going to take this pen and... Oh, I'm going to have to fill. Get it right. I think I'm doing a good job. I feel like I'm doing a good job. Get it a little bit more. Should I keep going or do more? Okay, so now I'm just going to blend out the front because that's what I normally do. I'm going to brush them up. I'm going to do the other side. Brush them up. I'm going to put my brow pen on. Oh. That messed up my whole look. Okay. I feel like this brow pen's a lot harder because it's like a tattoo ink brow pen, so hopefully that's good. Y'all let me know. You guys have to let me know because I don't know what I'm doing. Do a little bit of fading at the front and then I'm gonna blend it out. Okay, I think I'm done with that. That was pretty good, I feel like. It wasn't too bad. Alright, let's blend it out, brush it up. I knew I was forgetting something. When I can't see, I know I forget. Alright, the next thing I have to do is eyeliner. I'm going to use my new Kat Von D Tattoo Eyeliner. I'm really, really scared. Okay. This tattoo eyeliner is like so good. I don't know if I can. Oh, this is gonna be terrible. This is gonna be terrible. Feel this being terrible. I should've just done that in the first place. This one's probably a lot better than this one. General idea of what I'm doing. Okay, I think that's pretty good. I mean, that's as good as that was probably the hardest thing to do. I'm gonna set my face really quickly, use this Revolution setting spray, and I'm gonna fan it off. So I'm gonna set my face real quick. All this perfection of makeup on my face set because we don't want it to go nowhere. One of those mini fans that you can like do yourself. Oh, that's what I normally do. I pat it in. So let's pat it in. And let's pat it in, pat it in, pat it in. Okay. It's patted in. So the next thing I want to do is do my mascara. No, first I have to do my lower lashes. So I'm going to go back in with that Modern Renaissance where I can't see myself. I'm going to go back in with this dark brown orange and put this underneath my eye. Purple, and put that underneath too. I love that face I make. That's a beautiful face. Alright, now for mascara, I'm going to go in with the Better Than Sex mascara. I'm going to do one more time. Alright, I think that side's good. Do
And then I'm gonna do my bottom lashes really quick. I'm pretty sure I got mascara on my skin because I don't really do that with a mirror, so I'm gonna tell them what I did without a mirror. And the last thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do my lips, and I'm gonna use this Essence lip. This is a nude, and I'm just gonna put this on my lips. And I think that is the completed look. Now I have to reveal myself. And I'm pretty scared because I feel like my face makeup is pretty good. It's my eyes, my brows, and that's pretty much it that I feel like is ugh. But I'm gonna grab my mirror and I'm gonna take a look. Oh, I messed it up. Oh no! Anyway, I'm gonna look. I'm pretty scared because I want it to be good. Like, I have this sick feeling. I want it to be good. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, like, that is not as bad as I thought. Like, that liner, yeah, it's pretty bad, but it's mostly, like, filled in. And my brows are not, like, terrible either. Like, if you guys can see this, like, this looks pretty bad. I'm gonna turn on my viewfinder now so I can see what the camera's seeing and we can talk.
Guys, I just realized while I was trying to edit my video and importing my videos that I didn't even press record on my Canon camera. I didn't film an outro, but I was gonna quickly do one here. This is the makeup now that everything is done. My face. So yeah. Obviously, it's not perfect, but I had a lot of fun doing this challenge. I want to do more challenges like this. Liked it, please give it a thumbs up. Comment down below your thoughts and suggestions. And subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want to see more makeup content like this. Always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.